Today, I am going to showcase the current state of game emulation on iPhones using my iPhone 50, which is based 128GB of version. I'll show you how to set up the whole process. We'll be testing on two emulators and demonstrating how to install games for them. It's be a short video where I'll get straight to the point without dragging out unnecessary. So stay with me. By the way, I also have a separate iPhone 11 to test on a lower-end iPhone for a reference. Rest assured, if you have purchased a future iPhone model, these games will perform similarly, and newer iPhones will offer even better performance. As always, for legal reasons, I can't show you where to download these games from, but you can find them easily with a quick Google research or help from others in the comment section. If you are downloading games to your Mac or iPhone, make sure to download only from reputable sources to keep your iPhone safe from viruses and malware. Before we start the video, please take a moment to like and subscribe, because it takes a lot of time to download games, write a script, shoot and edit these videos all by myself. Once we covered that, let's move on to the video. The first emulator we are going to look at is classic PPSSPP, which is a trusted and well-known PSP emulator that has been available on multiple devices for years, including PC, Android and iOS. It's finally available on iOS, so we are excited to use it. PPSSPP is probably the easiest way to start with retro game emulation on iPhone. This emulator has plenty of settings to upscale your game resolution or fix bugs while emulating the game. You can tell PPSSPP is one of most well-built emulators around, and there are virtually no performance issues with any games we've tested, including games like God of War. In order to install PPSSPP on your iPhone, you just go to App Store and download it. But to be clear, let me show you which one is the right one. After downloading the app, you should install games to it, and I'm going to show you how. First of all, you should download the game to your PC or Mac. After you download it, connect your phone via USB. Click on Trust this device on both devices, iPhone and Mac. After that, go to Finder and click to your iPhone. In that menu, click on the Files tab. In here, you should see PPSSPP folder. This is where we put our games into. Just drag and drop the ISO file here and wait for the transformation. After this completes, let's go back to phone. So in the phone, I'm going to open the app real quick. And in the game section, my games show up. Pretty easy, right? Let me try to run the game, see if it works smoothly. I'm going to show you my settings to copy if you need to run smoothly like mine. I'm going to skip cutscenes real quick. I wanna play. About to get Sierra Hotel in here. It runs pretty smooth. After that, I'm going to try God of War. I know that so many people have problems running this game smoothly, so here's my experience right here. Quickly set difficulty and all.
Kratos, the ghost of Sparta, had taken his place.
I don't have an FPS counter, but I can tell you what I feel, and I feel it's 16 FPS. After this test, I'm going to test on my iPhone 11 running iOS 18. I mean, this is the one of the worst scenarios if you ask me. The weather is hot, therefore the phone is also hot. Running beta iOS and this phone is 5 years old. Let's see how it will perform under these circumstances. colors look so off after the iPhone 15. And as you can see, no problems at all. Let me check settings real quick. Oh, so it's renders at 2x PSP with no problems. I'm gonna try 1080p and check auto frame skip to see how it performs. And again, no problems whatsoever. If we have more up-to-date iPhones, you'll have no issues at all, but can't say anything about the low iPhone 11 since I have no access to them. The second emulator I'm going to show you is Delta. I know there are more complex and graphically advanced games available on App Store, but hear me out. I know there are people who enjoy playing old, retro, nostalgic and basic casual games on the go. This app allows you to play NES, SNES, Nintendo 64, Game Boy Color, Game Boy Advance and Nintendo DS games. Since these games are not very demanding, the emulator does not have complex settings like PPSSPP, making it easy to use and set up. So in order to use Delta, first of all, of course you need to download it. Go to App Store and download this app I show. Pretty simple. After that, you need to send the games to your phone. Just like what we did with the PSP games, but this time you should drop the games to the Delta section. Just drag and drop and you are good to go. After that, click on the plus icon on the upper right corner and then select your games. So that was the installation process. We can just click and play, right? Unfortunately, no. I purposefully selected DS games just because to show you this error. If you want to play DS games, it gives this error and let me tell you how to fix it. So I actually show you how to download the files and all, but looks like publishing sources is illegal, so unfortunately I am not showing anything, but you might want to google this site and take a look around it. So in order to install these files, transfer files from your Mac to your phone and go to Delta app. In the app, click one of the games and when this pops up, click import files. So for BIOS 7, choose BIOS NDS7. For BIOS 9, choose BIOS NDS9. And for firmware, choose firmware.bin. So that was the installation process for DS. As you can see, after we did that, we even got the DS main menu. So I'm going to try Pokemon to see how it works. I don't know why it has no sound, but I'll continue playing. Nintendo DS had two screens and one of them was touchscreen. When I was a child, I wanted to buy one of these DS's, but ended up with PSP, so I think I'm going to play with this DS emulator. So it looks like if your phone is on silent, emulator respects that and puts itself on silent too. If you want to play games with sound, you should check your ringer rocker. So this is the end of this video, thank you for watching it until this point. I hope you like my straightforward approach. If you enjoyed this video, you might want to check out the other videos on my channel. See you around. So I actually finished editing this video, but I realized I didn't give you the settings I was using on the PPSSPP. So there you go.